Next is a young woman who moved from Nashville to New York this year and seems bent on global domination. Her parents named her after James Taylor, and her fans are called Swifties. If you haven't guessed her name by now, you are clearly living under a very large rock. One magazine headline said it best, Taylor Swift is the music industry. Say there was one song this year that you just couldn't shake off. Shake It Off. Taylor Swift's giant hit single off her giant hit album, 1989 sold over a million copies its first week, unheard of these days, and was the only album to go platinum in 2014. The one-time teen country singer became a pop powerhouse this year. A one-woman exception to the rule that in the digital age, artists cannot make money selling records. This is your first album of all pop songs. Are you at all worried that you will lose some of the country fans?
I am not worried about that. I'm really in touch with my fans and I know what they like. What my fans in general were afraid of was that I would start making pop music and I would stop writing smart lyrics, or I would stop writing emotional lyrics. And when they heard the new music, they realized that that wasn't the case at all.
Taylor's success is based on her close relationship with her fans. They're called Swifties. They see themselves in her, and she sees herself in them.
Your fans feel so personal about you. I mean, you're the only one I know who invites people back into your house. Do you still do that?
Yeah. I decided that I wanted to play this entire album for the fans long before it came out. I wanted it to be like this little secret society gatherings and living rooms, and so I decided to have them in my houses.
We have 89 fans waiting in the living room. I've also heard about the entire 1989 record.
Hey, guys!
I want to come up with as many ways that we can spend time together and bond, because it keeps me normal. It keeps my life feeling manageable.
Is your life at all normal?
No.
No.
Not at all. And that's why when I go online and I go on Instagram and I see, you know, a post from Emma, who lives in Philadelphia, and she's talking about how her day was at school that day, that helps me.
You still do that?
It's the only thing that keeps me not feeling overwhelmed by the abnormality of my life.
What's the most abnormal?
The most abnormal thing about my life is having sort of crowds form everywhere you go. And just everywhere. So that starts happening, and then you have to take security everywhere you go. All of a sudden, you realize that you have not been alone, truly, for 5 years.
Taylor has been a star writing and singing her own songs from the time she was 16, when her first country music album debuted. And your mama don't know. Since then, she's won just about every music award there is.
It's exciting.
Growing up before our eyes.
Thank you so much.
She wears short skirts, I wear t-shirts. She's cheer captain and I'm on the bleachers.
Her autobiographical songs deal with the problems of growing up and having or not having relationships.
If you could see me, I'm the one who understands you.
But while her fans identify, critics have accused her of being too autobiographical.
You belong with me.
If a guy shares his experience in writing, he's brave. If a woman shares her experience in writing, she's oversharing. And she's over-emotional, or she might be crazy, or watch out, she'll write a song about you.
Yeah, well, there is that.
But that joke is so old. And it's coming from a place of such sexism.
As she has become more famous, so have the boyfriends.
I'll write your name. Boys only want love if it's torture.
Her hits are a chronicle of high-profile relationships that blossom, wither, die, and then get turned into song lyrics. But just as her music has changed, so has her attitude toward romance.
And I'll write your name.
It seems like when I moved to New York, love and heartbreak and all the themes that used to be main factors in my music kind of faded to the background. Of course, love is still very interesting to me as a writer, but...
As a writer, not as a beautiful young woman?
Not right now.
No?
I just am really happy and I'm really protective of that.
Everybody here was someone else before, and you can want who you want. Boys and girls, welcome to New York. It's been waiting for you. Welcome to New York. Welcome to New York. Welcome to New York. It's been waiting for you. Welcome to New York. Welcome to New York. Welcome to New York.
Finally, the most fascinating person of the year when we return.